When I realized it's been 40 years since the Beatification, I was looking at my pictures and the album was all falling apart because the glue was drying up.
One of the things I remember was just when we were hearing about it, that Catherine Kasper was going to be beatified. To be honest, I didn't know what that really meant in the church history. But I was glad to know that they were going to invite several of us sisters to go. So we were going to have some kind of a raffle. And it was like, well, I was one of the youngest ones, so I figured I would not be chosen.
I was at St. Augustine's at the time, and we were about 20-some sisters. We had the high school and the grade school, and we knew there was just no way that we were going to be able to just stop school and go. But we figured that at least some people might get a chance if they put their name in the hat. So we all agreed that if someone got to go, we'd see that they were covered, you know, in the classrooms.
And then we found out that anyone who said that they were able to go and could go were invited to take the trip.
Our trip to the Beatification started in Germany. And we had several days there. And the sisters had many places to take us. There was so much to see in Germany.
I can still feel the, or sense that feeling that I had when the bus was driving into Dernbach and I could see the steeple of the Mother House.
Having the bus stop in front of the Mother House Chapel when they picked us up from the airport, and we all went into chapel at that time, and of course Mother Mary's remains were not under the altar at that time. They were to the left of us as we came in a really beautiful gated area. And the sense of the presence of Blessed Catherine there.
Also, realizing that Catherine was a small town girl growing up, and the greatness and what she did in her life in founding the Poor Handmaids. I realized that six of us from a small town of Trenton were on this trip together, and we had our picture taken at the front of the Mother House, the front door. It was just so amazing that we could be in the presence and walk the streets and the grounds where Catherine did.
But it wasn't until the day before we left that we got a free afternoon and we were free to go to the Heilborn. And part of the Heilborn's mystique is the solitude there. And I went up to the front and I felt that solitude. I felt as if I were the only person there. And what I heard was, there is no magic in this place. The Heilborn is in your heart.
I was awestruck at the sight of the linden tree towering over that tiny chapel. And after spending time both outside and inside and just imagining Catherine being there, There was a connection that I felt with Catherine that I had not felt before. Just a closeness, just knowing that she was there and I was in that same spot.
Just being in Germany, walking where she walked, seeing this part of the Mother House now that remains, that was just a small section of the original part. I mean, just all of those brought home to me, I think, the reality of the values that she lived, her simplicity, her caring for the poor, her just small steps, and the importance of just doing what you can, doing what the Lord brings before us in small ways, that's enough and that's important. Those were the lessons that really came home to me walking where she walked in Germany.
The thing that I remember most is the vastness of everything. St. Peter's was so big, and that courtyard is huge. And when you get inside, the statue of St. Peter is immense. And it was so crowded.
This was Pope Paul VI's last canonization mass. And I can remember them carrying him on his chair, and processing through the basilica, and I was sitting to the left of the altar, and they walked right by.
And I remember when Paul VI entered St. Peter's Basilica, just how frail he looked. It was April, and then he died the following August. And then John Paul I was Pope for like 33 days, and then John Paul II.
The Honorable Servant of God, Maria Katharina Kasper, shall henceforth be called blessed.
And I remember at one point when Pope Paul VI was announcing the beatification, saying, Catherine is now Blessed Catherine. I looked up, for some reason or other, I just looked up and I saw this flutter come down, and it was a veil unveiling a picture of Blessed Catherine way up on top of the cathedral.
Behind the altar was this veiled image. Ordinarily, the Holy Spirit is pictured there. But on that day, when the veil fell, the image of Mother Catherine came out.
But it was clear, just really clear and beautiful. Really bright lights there, and it was just like she was appearing from heaven.
The feeling really is sort of indescribable. My heart was just so overcome with joy, and tears just silently flowed.
And it was such an emotional moment. I think we were clapping and crying all at the same time.
And I can remember poking one another as we were in the basilica and pointing to that. And I can just remember the awe and the gasp and the feeling of pride and even the tears that came to people. We were so proud and just pinching ourselves that we're actually here and this is actually happening.
After the beatification, it was not the day of the beatification, it was the day after. We had another session with the Holy Father, and it was in the plenary hall, which is not the same as the big cathedral. But a number of us were asked to have a private audience with Pope Paul VI.
And there were, I guess, about 40 of us, so the note said. And I thought, well, okay, we'll probably be able to go in the room. We'll all stand there. And they did tell us we could actually kiss the ring of the Holy Father. And I thought, okay, we just have to kneel down, kiss the ring, and get in with this big circle of people. Well, it didn't happen that way. When we went in there, we each got called individually.
And each of us was given a special rosary, and then photographers were around to snap our pictures.
I remember him saying my name, and the Pope responded, Germany. And I said something, and I don't even know what I said, and he went, America. So I remember saying something about we are thankful to be here and that everyone sends greetings from America to you. And, you know, and that's all I remember. I don't remember what he all said.
Somehow this beatification was God's gift to us as poor handmaids, because what it did is really make us very aware of our foundress. Up until this point, we knew about her, knew the name, probably read a few books that, you know, we had to read about her. But she wasn't a real person, at least to me, she wasn't. And with this beatification, it made her a real person, because all of a sudden, we weren't that daughter community province across the ocean. I never felt a connection. In fact, we often talked about, you know, there is no connection between us and Germany, only this every 6 years that we would meet. But here we were, really with sisters from all over the world, united for this one event of really recognizing the woman who truly brought us together.
To be a part and a witness and a member of hundreds of sisters all gathered together, it really was such an overwhelming sense of unity within the diversity of who we all are as an international congregation.
One of the things that was for me an unexpected joy and blessing was meeting the sisters from other countries that were poor handmaids all of us followers of Catherine. It was kind of cool. I mean, I knew that we were an international congregation, but that really made it strike home for me.
So it was very, very special to feel that the whole community was together. You know, I think that's when a sense of our internationality became real.
I think prior to that time, especially, we knew we were an international congregation, but that was just a little piece of knowledge we had in the back of our head. We hadn't met many other international sisters. Well, the general leadership when they came for visitation, but that was about all. We really hadn't met sisters in ministry like we were from around the world. And so at the time of the beatification, I can recall how thrilled we were to meet sisters from Germany and from India. But that was the first time, I think, that we, for me, it registered our internationality and the richness and the meaningfulness of that.
And we've kept up this knowledge of getting to know her better. We have biographies that have been written since that time. We've had our GPR meetings. We've had all kinds of international meetings, opportunities really for sisters to come together, to go from one province to the other province. So it's really something that I think that we were blessed as a community somehow or other at that time to really come together and be one. And it had its beginning there.